الرحمن الرحيم. مشاهدينا الكرام، طلبات وطالبات شهادة دبلوم التعليم العام، أسعد الله أوقاتكم بكل خير. أهلا بكم معنا في هذا اليوم الرائع والجميل، وفي هذا النهار الذي من خلاله نتواصل معكم وعبر برنامج درس على الهواء. نبدأ اليوم في حلقات اللغة الإنجليزية، حلقة اليوم وهناك أيضا حلقة قادمة بإذن الله. بالتأكيد أديت اليوم الامتحان في مادة الفيزياء، نتمنى لكم كل التوفيق إن شاء الله في الامتحانات القادمة. بالنسبة لحلقة اللغة الإنجليزية، سيكون نظام الحلقة كما هو متبع في السنوات السابقة. نستعرض في البداية الورقة الامتحانية، وطبعا عارفين احنا عندنا في مادة اللغة الإنجليزية اللي هي اللغة الإنجليزية A واللغة الإنجليزية B، سواء لطلاب التعليم الأساسي أو طلاب التعليم العام. بعد ما نستعرض الورقة الامتحانية للامتحانين راح نستقبل أسئلتكم. طبعا الحوار، ونؤكد على هذه النقطة دائما، الحوار مع المعلمين ضيوف البرنامج راح يكون باللغة الإنجليزية، وطرح الأسئلة راح يكون باللغة الإنجليزية معي أنا كمقدم للبرنامج، استثناء أن يكون الحوار باللغة العربية ولا يهمكم. عموما شوي ونبدأ الحلقة، خليكم معنا. أهلا بكم مجددا مشاهدي الكرام، طلبة وطالبات الصف الثاني عشر. بعد هالفاصل الطويل شوية راح نبدأ إن شاء الله حلقة اليوم ومادة اللغة الإنجليزية. اسمحوا لي باسمكم أن أرحب بضيفي هذه الحلقة، الأستاذ سعيد بن محمد العمري معلم لغة إنجليزية. حياك معنا أستاذ سعيد. يا مرحبا وسهلا. وطبعا أستاذ سعيد راح يتولى الإجابة على الأسئلة والاستفسارات الخاصة بمادة اللغة الإنجليزية بي. أيضا وكما تعودنا وضيفتنا من السنوات الماضية الأستاذة فاطمة بنت عبد الله البريكية معلمة لغة إنجليزية. حياك معنا أستاذة فاطمة. وراح تكون إن شاء الله مع طلبة الأي يعني بالتأكيد. أنتوا خليكم جاهزين الحين. شو اللي بيصير؟ راح نستعرض الورقة الامتحانية، شكل الامتحان. راح يمر الأساتذة على الأسئلة سؤال سؤال بالتوضيح. ربما الكثير منكم عندهم الامتحانات التجريبية، أتمنى تكون حاضرة معاكم هذه الامتحانات وتكونوا متابعين. هو أعتقد الامتحان التجريبي صح؟ الامتحان التجريبي هو اللي راح يستعرضوه. أتمنى يكون الامتحان معاكم. وطبعا بتقولوا طيب احنا عندنا الامتحان ليش تستعرضوه؟ احنا نستعرضوه عشان الأساتذة يوضحوا لكم يا نقطة نقطة وشو مطلوب منك انت كطالب لما تجاوب على هالسؤال، شو المطلوب انك تسوي وكيف تتعامل مع هذا السؤال. طبعا بعد ما يخلص الأستاذ سعيد مستعرض الآخر امتحان اللي هو الامتحان بي، راح نفتح المجال للاتصالات وأيضا ناخذ الأسئلة عن طريق الفيسبوك وعن طريق التويتر. والأسئلة يا تكون مرتبطة بالامتحان يا تكون مرتبطة بالكتاب المدرسي. أيضا راح نتيح لكم الفرصة أنكم تعملوا نوع من الحوار في بعض الأسئلة الواردة في الامتحانات كنوع من التنشيط بالنسبة لكم. ونبدأ في استعراض أول امتحان اللي هو امتحان اللغة الإنجليزية الإنجليزية A. تفضل أستاذة فاطمة.
Okay, so here we have, this is the exam paper of English language A. If we just leave the first page where you have to write, where are the marks should be written. Let's move to the first question. The first question is going to be the listening, as you know. And here, listening number one has from 1 to 7 items. If we just look at the question here, you have to read the question here carefully and try to read all the sub-questions that you have here before the teacher comes with the tape recorder so that you are in the view of what's going to be the examination, what's going to be the listening question. So it is very important that you read the rubric. The rubric here says, for example, you are going to hear a conversation between two people who have studied in the UK. Listen and shade in the bubble next to the correct option. Then here we have the first one. Like each question has 3 items and you have to choose the correct item. Try not to choose more than 1 item because if you circle onto or if you shade 2 bubbles, it means the answer will be wrong. Make sure that you only choose 1. Okay? Try to answer the listening question from the first time you hear the listening script. Then if we just look at question listening number 2, it has from 8 to 15 items. Part number 1, it has WH questions where you have to write a short answer, but make sure that not more than 4 words for this question. If we just look here at the WH question, it's very important that you know that each WH word, what does it mean? So that when you write the answer, you write exactly what the question wants from you. If we just look here, we have here what. We know that the word what here ask about something, and here we have how was it transported along the Amber Road. So here we have by. So the word here how here ask you to write about this certain information, which you have here also to make sure that whatever here WH word, be careful with it. Do you have, for example, why, where you have to write a reason? Do you have to write who, where you have to write a name of people or person? Do you have to write here how many, so that you write a number or what? So make sure that you answer the question accurately. If we just move to part number 2, part number 2 again here you have W, you have multiple choice question where you have to choose the correct option from the options provided here. If we just look to The second question will be vocabulary. As you know that here you have two vocabulary questions. This is vocabulary number one. You have here a box of, inside the box you have a text. You have to complete the text with words that you have here. Under the text, you have to choose the correct option from the words that you have here. Each question of vocabulary question has half mark. Let's move to vocabulary number two. With this vocabulary question, you are given like the first letter or two letters or three letters of the word where you have to complete and write the word. Make sure that you spell the word correctly because spelling here is very important. If you add a letter or if you omit a letter, it means that the whole word will be wrong. Let's move to the second question. The second question here, as you know, we have here the grammar. Again, the grammar here, you have two speakers talking about something. And here you have to complete the grammar question or the sentence or the statement that you have. And the completion will be choosing words from the books that you have here under the table. If we just go to grammar number two, complete each sentence with one word only. Make sure that here in each place you only write one word, not more than one word. And if you just look at the question or the statement or the sentence that you have here, you can immediately get the word which the question wants you to write. I mean here write before the dash and after the dash always so that you can determine which word is here. Let's move to reading number one. You have here a text, and under the text you have multiple choice questions. First of all, read the question, then go to the text to find the answer. The number two, reading two, you have here WH questions. Again, very important to know the WH word so that you can be able to write the answer. Make sure with the reading question, not more than four words. So the marker of this reading question are going to read only the first four words you write. So don't write long paragraph or long sentences. Let's move here to part number two. You have here to choose the correct option from the options provided. If we just look at the last one, the last question will be the writing. Writing number one, you only have here two writing questions. Writing number one is the opinion writing, where you have to say, do you agree or disagree? Are you with the statement or against the statement? And then after that, you have to write an essay based on your opinion. And this question has 10 marks. After that, we have writing number two. You have a box of information, like words, verbs, adjective, whatever you have here, and then you have set of pictures where you have to write a story about the pictures that you have here. I wish you all the best, inshallah, in your examination. This is all about the English A.
إذن هذا كان استعراض للورقة الامتحانية بالنسبة لمادة اللغة الإنجليزية. مثل ما ذكرت في بداية الحلقة أكيد الامتحانات معكم أو أنكم حصلتوا عليها عن طريق المنتدى التربوي أو أيضا عن طريق أي موقع آخر وكنتم متابعين مع الأستاذة فاطمة. الآن راح نستعرض امتحان اللغة الإنجليزية بي وبعد كذا راح ناخذ اتصالاتكم. ممكن نعمل نقاش أيضا حتى على أسئلة الامتحان نفسها أو حتى أيضا على الأسئلة الواردة في الكتاب. تفضل أستاذ سعيد.
السلام عليكم. Hello guys. Wanna explain English language B exam. Wanna say before that the exam will be in five sections. The first page of course for marks. Let's leave it. Let's go to the first page and for the first section, which is listening number one. Listening number one will be in six questions. So if you read, you are going to hear a conversation between two people. Listen and shade the bubble next to the correct option. So here I want to give you an advice, guys. You need to read before the teachers coming and play the tape. So you need to read the questions carefully. For example, number one, the woman works at school, university, or ministry. So here, during the conversation, you could know where the woman is working, school, university, or ministry. So here we have six questions in listening number one. Let's go to listening number two. You will have five questions, five WH questions, and you need to hear very carefully here, guys, as well. And you need to write as short as you can from number seven. Number seven, eight, nine, 10, and 11. As much as you can write, yeah, just make it short. Don't write to a story here. So as much as you can, just not more than four words. Not, yeah, sentences or something like that. Let's go to listening number three. You are going to hear people speaking. Where are they? So try to know, where are they talking? Where? At the airport, in a car, plane, hospital, football stadium, or in a bus. So during your listening, try to make sure that you need to get where are they. So for one, two, three, and four. So three listening questions in section number one. So now we'll go to section number two, which is vocabulary. In vocabulary, we have two questions, vocabulary number one and vocabulary number two. Vocabulary number one, you will have a text with gaps. You need to make sure to choose the suitable word for each gap. And you are going to have for each gap four choices. You need to choose the suitable one. So try to read very carefully here and try to choose the best answer. Of course, correct one. Vocabulary number two. Also, you are going to have five gaps. But here something is different. You will be given for each a definition, and you will have a word. It's not a word actually. It's missing word, which is written just the first letters of these words. So you need to complete the word. So please try to read the definition first, then try to continue. Let's move to third section, which is grammar. In a grammar question, you are going to have five questions or five gaps as well. And here, you need to read very carefully. Of course, all grammar rules that we have studied so far, it may be applied here. So you need to read and choose the multiple one, or the correct one, sorry. Let's go to the grammar two. You will have five questions as well. Try to complete them. Try to think. Nobody will help you here. No books, nothing, no multiple choices. Just think and try to write the correct answer. Let's move to reading here. In reading, you are going to have three questions. Reading number one, reading number two, and reading number three. Reading number one will be seven questions, and you need to complete as well. Try to read and find what is the best completion here. Try to read very carefully and try to shade what's the best bubble here. Reading number two. Reading number two, I have two tickets, ticks one and ticks two. Ticks one is kind of letter here as an example, and you will get three multiple choices questions you need to answer as well. Ticks number two, also a ticks, small one, and try to read it as soon as possible and try to find the correct answer as well. Try to read questions before you answer, guys. Long one, to reading number three. Reading number three is a text as well. Before reading a text, guys, try to go to the questions. Try to read the questions very carefully. Read them one time and for a second time as well, and then go back and read. So this is the advice for all reading. Try to read questions before reading the tickets. Why? Because you don't have to waste time while you're reading the tickets, then reading the questions again, then go back and read the tickets. So do it just in once. Read the questions, go back and read the tickets as well. And the last section, writing. We're going to have three writing, guys. Writing number one, two, and three as well. So writing number one, you need to describe a picture. Oh, similar questions every year. In describing a picture, guys, you need to focus on three things. The first thing, describe what's happening. Then comment. Try to write what's happening in front of you, guys. And the third thing, giving advice. So three things, very important, describe picture, describe, comment, and give advice. Writing number two, try to give your opinion about a topic. Of course, topics will be changed from year to year. Nothing will be similar. Living in a small family is better than living in a big family. Good. So you need to discuss here, guys, agree or disagree as well. First thing here, you need to brainstorm. Make introduction, body, conclusion. Again, introduction, body, conclusion. And the last one, writing number three. Writing three, six pictures from one to six, a box of words, adjectives, verbs, nouns, or whatever, and you need to write a story. A story happened in the past, so tense will be past. So you need to write a story here using words in the box and describing the six pictures. Make it live and make us happy when we read it. Thank you very much, guys. Wish you all the best.
شكرا استاذ سعيد. ايضا اتمنى يكون التوضيح واضح بالنسبه لكم. للامتحانين اللغه الانجليزيه A and B راح نتلقى استفساراتكم واسئلتكم سواء المتعلقات بالورقه الامتحانيه او ايضا من خلال منهج اللغه الانجليزيه الكتاب سواء عبر الفيسبوك او حتى عبر التويتر وعبر الاتصالات. ناخذ اتصال معنا اول مكالمه في حلقه اليوم. السلام عليكم.
السلام.
ويا مرحبا وسهلا. من معنا؟
مروه.
مروه من وين يا مروه؟
بهله.
من بهله. مروه اي اور بي؟
اي.
اي تفضلي استاذه فاطمه.
هلو مروه، هاو ار يو؟
Yeah, it's fine.
How are the exams so far?
What?
How are the exams so far?
Good.
Okay.
Teacher?
Yes?
What the tab for writing?
Which one?
In exam.
You mean the question, the writing questions?
Yes. What the tab? King.
بالنسبة للامتحان اللي هي أسئلة الرايتنج تقصدي؟
Yes.
شو سؤالك بالضبط؟ تعطينا إياه بالعربي؟
أنواع الرايتنج اللي جات في الامتحان وطريقة كتابتها.
شفت الأستاذة فاطمة لما استعرضت الامتحان؟
ما انتبهت.
اها تمام، انت قصدك the type of the writing questions صح؟ تمام استاذة فاطمة. راح نعيدهم كذا على السريع وممكن حتى تعملي نوع من النقاش مع الاستاذة فاطمة على اساس في ولو سؤال واحد منهم. تمام؟
تمام.
يلا خليكي مع الاستاذة فاطمة مروة. طيب
اوكي مروة.
اوكي.
Look here, you have two writing questions only with for students who have English A. Each question has 10 marks. The total will be 20 marks for the two questions. Writing number one, it's going to be like this. A question where you have to write your opinion about. Okay, Marwa? For example, if we just look at this one, write at least 100 words on the following topic. Dangerous drivers should be severely punished by the police to make Oman's road safer. Do you agree or disagree with this statement? So generally, writing number one will be like opinion question or persuasive question writing, where you have to say your opinion. Do you agree, for example, or disagree with this statement? And then you have to say the reasons. Why do you agree or why do you disagree? Okay, Marwa? If we just look here at the first, I have here like this might help you students. I think that both English A and English B, they have both of them, they have the, what do we call it, like opinion question. If we just look here with opinion question, it's based, first of all, you have to look at the question or the statement that you have. Read it carefully and try to determine your opinion. Are you with or against the phrase? Or are you with or against the statement? Do you agree or disagree? So this is the first step you have to put in your mind. Do you agree or disagree? So the question will be like this. First of all, you have to write an introduction where in the introduction you have to put or state your opinion. So for example, if we have a question about Oman's roads and about driving, you have to say that nowadays everyone has a car. Driving is very important. Then, like from one sentence to two sentences. Then after that, at the end of the introduction, try to make your opinion. What is your opinion? Like, for example, you can say, I agree that, then you write the statement that you have or the sentence, or I disagree that, then you have the statement that you have in the examination. After you write the statement, you have to write the word because. After because, this is you have to write the reason. Which reasons do you have for your, for example, opinion? Try to make from 2 to 3 reasons. Where finally, your essay will look like this shape that we have here. Introduction. In the introduction, you have from 2 to 3 sentences, general sentences. By the end of the introduction, you write your opinion. What is your opinion? Then what are the reasons? Reason number one will be in one paragraph. Reason number two will be in two paragraph. Paragraph number two, if you have 3 reasons, you can write it. Generally, with the essay, you can write from 2 to 3 reasons to support your idea. Don't write just one reason so that you can get the full mark, inshallah. Then after that, you move to the conclusion. In the conclusion, you have to summarize the points you have already said. Like, for example, it is very important to drive a car nowadays, but we have to keep our roads in Oman safer by doing this and this and this. Okay? So this is regarding the first writing. The second writing will be the story. As we know with the story might come in two versions, actually. Sometimes, as we have it here this year with grade 10, where they only give them the beginning of the story, like one sentence or two sentences, and they have to complete a story or write a story. So you have to put this in your mind. You don't know. The second one, which we used to have it every year, is that we have a box. Inside the books, we have words, and under the books, we have pictures. You will ask me, how can we answer this type of question? You can answer it very carefully. The first step you have to do is that you have to look at the pictures that you have here. Try to understand the events, first of all, from the pictures. Then go to the books that you have, see which words will help you in which picture. You have to start the story with a word or a phrase that tells the reader he is reading a story, or the marker, the teacher who mark your paper. What are the words you can write? Like, for example, one day, once upon a time. Sometimes you have here an indication for the time, like last week. Then start writing your story. Make sure that all the verbs here have to be in the past simple. Why? Because you are writing a story, you are narrating a story, something that had already happened and finished. With this type of opinion, make sure that with opinion, you have to express the opinion using present simple. Unless you want to tell about something that might happen in the future, you can write future sentence. Or if you want to compare something happened in the past, you can write about the past. This is all about the writing a question for English A.
شكرا استاذة فاطمة. ايضا مروة اتمنى تكوني متابعتنا وتعرفتي على اسئلة رايتنج. مروة موجودة معنا؟ مروة ناخذ اتصال اخر. السلام عليكم. ناخذ اتصال. السلام عليكم. يا مرحبا وسهلا، من معنا؟
هبة.
هبة؟ ايوه. من وين يا هبة؟
نزوة.
من نزوة؟
ايوه.
هبة، ما عليه، يعني لما الأساتذة بيشرحوا لكم أو يناقشوكم كونوا معاهم على أساس أيضا يكون نوع من التجاوب، أو حتى أي شيء أنتم ما فاهمينه أو ما واضح بالنسبة لكم ممكن حتى تتداخلوا أثناء شرحهم هم. يعني هالكلام كنت أريد أقوله لمروة، وراح أقول أيضا لكل الطلبة اللي راح يتصلوا فينا مرة ثانية، أنكم ما تخلوكم فقط ساكتين، وبعدين ما تخافوا من اللغة الإنجليزية، هي لغة جميلة. تمام يا هبة؟
ان شاء الله.
انت ايه ولا بي؟
ايه.
ايه تفضلي.
أيوه.
تفضلي.
يس هبه.
هلو تيتشر.
هلو، هاو ار يو؟
I am fine. What about you?
Fine. Are you ready for the exam?
Yes.
Okay. What's your question?
Teacher, I need you explain past passive and past symbol. How can change past symbol and past passive?
Okay. Inshallah, I will tell you about it. Just try to follow, okay?
Okay.
عندك سؤال آخر هبة؟
No.
يلا موفقة إن شاء الله. شكرا لك يا هبة.
آمين إن شاء الله.
Okay, regarding this question, we have to look here, look at the board, and also if you want to look at the book, you have here in the book like the past simple and past passive. We have it in page number 5 in the course book. And let's look here at the board and let's see what do we mean by past simple and past passive. Okay, with past simple, if we just look at the sentence will consist of subject plus verb plus object. Then here we have the full stop. Actually, with this verb, we have to know that with past simple, we have the verb that ends with AD, which is the regular verb, or the irregular verb where have the verb can change. Like, for example, we may have go, and when it changed to the past, it becomes went. So here we have, with past verbs, we have regular verbs and irregular verbs. Okay, so you have to look at these two things. You have to know them. What's the difference between them? You have to learn them, actually. Then if we just look here at the past simple, we have here from this example, you will know the difference. Let's see the first one. Let's say that, for example, the subject is Reem. Reem opened the door. If we look here at this subject, the subject here is Reem, and we have here the action that she did. What did she do? She opened the door. So here we have a subject who did an action, and this action took place in the past. Okay, so this is with past simple. What are the keywords that come in the sentence and help me to know that this verb is past simple? Let's look here. One of the keywords that comes is that we have, sometimes we have the word last, last week, last year, for example, last month. We may also have the word ago. We also may have in plus a date in the past, like in 2002. This we consider to be the past. We also may have, like, for example, the word we have here, last, we have ago, we have in plus a date in the past, and also we may have the word yesterday. It also means past. We may also have, like, for example, a phrase like in the past. When I have this phrase, it means that the verb took place in the past. So this is about past simple. Now let's see the sentence that I wrote for past simple is that Reem then opened the door. And we said that this is past simple. We have here an action, which is opening the door, and this action done by Reem. Let's change this sentence from past simple to past active. This sentence we call it active because here we have the subject. If I have a sentence without subject, where the object took place becomes number one, we call this sentence a passive sentence. Why it is passive? Because the subject is not there. Let's look at this one. We said that this is subject, this is verb, and here we have object. Let's change this from past simple to past passive. It will become like this. The first thing we are going to do is that here, we are going to delete the subject. We will not have the subject. The sentence will, it will be like this. The door. Then we write here something. The verb here, the shape of the verb or the form of the verb will change. it will be like having was opened. Then we will put here full stop. If I ask you here in this sentence, who opened the door? The subject is not there, which means that this sentence here is passive. The rule of the passive is that you have object, then you have was or were, then you have the past participle, then you have the complement of the sentence, and finally the full stop. If the object here is singular, you will have was, like for example, it, he, or she, whatever you have here. Then if you have here, the object here is a plural, you are going to write where. And remember that here we have past simple and past passive. This is the past passive.
إذن هبة أتمنى أيضا تكون متابعة معنا. شكرا لك أستاذة فاطمة. نأخذ من التويتر تغريدة وسؤال من أسماء من السويق. هذا لك أستاذ سعيد. تقول what type of writing will come in the exam English B. إحنا وضحنا لكن أيضا ما يمنعنا نعيده مرة ثانية.
It's okay to review again and again. Writing questions will be guys three writings. Writing number one. Writing number two and writing number three. Just to show writing questions, writing number one will be a picture and you need to describe it. Normal question. As I said again and again, while you are seeing a picture, try to describe it, comment, and give advice. Three things is very important. Describe it. For example, I can see in the picture, blah, 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 or whatever. So I can see in the picture, very simple. Or you can say, this picture shows. And try to describe, for example, this picture. I can see in the picture, women, policemen, and a car, and whatever. You describe it. Comment, the second one, what's happening now? The police doing what, for example, for helping a woman, for example, or what? When you finish comment the picture, try to give advice. For example, you can say, I advise all driver to check, for example, wheels before driving. Very important. So describe, comment, and advice. The second question, writing number two, is giving opinion, as the teacher explained before. Giving opinion, agree, or no, this one, writing number two, yeah. Writing number two, opinion questions, so agree or disagree. Again. Try to put that one in your mind. Brainstorm it. Give introduction. For example, students should have their decision alone or classroom every day or whatever. Try to give, what can I say, agree or disagree more than one reason. Reason number one, reason number two, reason number three, and conclusion. So here, give introduction, 3 to 4 sentences. Give reasons, main body, 2 to 3 paragraphs, and conclusion. For example, you can say in conclusion and write a sentence or 2 to 3 sentences here. And the last one, writing number three, a story. You will be given 6 pictures, guys. Very important that the 6 pictures are given to help you, and a box of words. These words maybe could be verbs, adjectives, adverbs, and nouns. You can use these words to help you are writing a story. You can start here with one very important. You can start once upon a time, or you can start with one day. Here, the tense is past simple since the story is happening in the past. Yeah, very important that you need to mention that you are using past simple here. So again, three writing number one, two, and three. All the best.
إذن أسماء أيضا أتمنى تكون متابعتنا من خلال شاشة التلفزيون. طبعا لأن السؤال كان عبر تويتر وتعرفتي على الإجابة. كثير من الطلبة يستفسروا بالنسبة للامتحانات التجريبية كيف ممكن يحصلوها. أستاذة فاطمة وأستاذ سعيد يعني وين موجودة؟ هل موجودة على المنتدى أو شيء الامتحان التجريبي هذا؟ أو هل ممكن يكون متاح على الأيام الجاية إذا ما موجود؟ يعني حاجيك يمكن يتبرع ويحطه.
If they are looking for practice exam, they can go just to ministry website, moe.gov.om, and they can go to Zawiyati corner, just click on it, and they need to choose their classes from number one, from class number one to class 12, from grade 1 to grade 12. When they are choosing their grades, they can, the window will be like giving the subjects. So, and you need to choose the, yeah, choose the subject, and all exams regarding to this subject will be shown there. Just choose the exam of the year that you are looking for and download it. So you can go to ministry website, moe.gov.om, Zawiyati corner, click on it, then go to the subject that you are looking for, the grade, and then the subject, then the year of the exam that you are looking for.
زاويتي اعتقد موجوده في المنتدى يعني مش في في صفحه البوابه.
The portal.
داخل المنتدى، يفتح المنتدى التربوي في البوابه بس لان انا شفتها بعد في المنتدى ايضا يمكن ايضا موجوده في البوابه.
And the forum, in the forum also there is.
في المنتدى موجوده فوق كذا الايقونه ماله زاويتي وممكن تعملوا عليها كليك وتدخلوا داخل زاويتي وراح تحصلوا الامتحانات يعني لاكثر من امتحان صح؟
More than I think yeah hundreds of exams for all subjects hundreds. Also they can find some quizzes done by teachers. They can find.
واعتقد انه
activities also. Yeah.
جميل. وهذا مشروع جميل ايضا الوزاره قائم عليه وزاره التربيه والتعليم انها تحط مجموعه من الاسئله مجموعه من التمارين مجموعه ايضا من الاسئله القصيره داخل هذه النافذه النافذه الجديده اللي هي زاويتي اللي موجوده في المنتدى التربوي وفي البوابه في بوابه سلطنه عمان التعليميه في المنتدى موجوده في الواجهه على طول فوق بامكانكم توصلوا لها. ناخذ اتصال السلام عليكم.
عليكم السلام.
يا مرحبا وسهلا من معانا؟ من؟
رزان.
رزان من وين؟
من الخابورة.
من الخابورة، اي اور بي يا رزان؟
ايه.
ايه. تفضلي مع السادة فاطمة.
يس رزان.
How are you teacher?
I'm fine. What about you?
الحمد لله.
Okay, nice. What's your question?
Teacher, I want to explain me about the rule about modal verbs.
About what?
Modal verbs.
Modal verbs?
Yes.
You mean the one that you have in theme number 4?
Yes.
Okay. Let's look here. Okay, Razan, inshallah.
Okay.
Wish you all the best. Okay, the question that she's asking about, it's in page 53, and here the modal verbs. Actually, there are a lot of modal verbs in English language, but what we have here in this page is some of the modal verbs. If we just look at these modal verbs, the first one here we have well, and here we have may, and also we have might. If we just look here at them, the first thing that you have to know regarding modal verbs is that we have here well, may, and also here we have might. Razan, do you know what type of verb comes after this? Razan, are you with me?
Yes.
Do you know what type of verbs comes after these three modal verbs that I wrote here on the screen?
Be, I will be.
What do you mean with be?
يعني will be do that.
Yes. We call them what? The. The basic verbs, Razan. Right.
Right.
Yes, you are going to teach your friends today instead of me. Okay. So
okay.
The verbs that we have here after. Always the verbs that comes after well, may, might. We also have other verbs like must, mustn't, should, shouldn't, and also we have the word to. Always the verbs that come after these type of verbs is the basic verbs. The basic verbs here mean, we mean by them what? The infinitive. It means what? The verbs has no s, no ed, no ing. Okay, so okay. This is the first thing you have to know, what type of verbs comes after these modal verbs. Then let's look at the meaning of these. What does well mean, Razan? What does it mean, the word well? What does it mean?
إذن رزان ما موجودة معنا خلاص انت كمل الان
بدل. Okay. I thought that she will be the teacher today. Okay, let's look here. We have here the word, the first word here we have will, may, and might. These three words, we use them to express the future, to talk about the future. There is a difference between them regarding the meaning. We know that here the word might is the past word of the word may. But as we have it here in the book, is that we use will when we are somehow sure that something is going to happen. Then after the word will, in possibility, we have the word may. Then after the word may, we have the word might. So this is the order of them in telling someone or expressing that something is going to happen in the future. So the more stronger is the word will, then less than will we have may, and less than may we have the word might. Be careful with the meaning. All of them, we use them to express the future. The verb that comes after them, all of them, they are infinitive verb. It means verb without S, without ED, and without ING. And I can here add others so that the students can benefit. We also have the word must and the negative mustn't. We also have the word should and also shouldn't. We sometimes also we may have the word to, like the preposition. After to, if there is a verb, the verb always have to be in the infinitive. No S, no ED, no ING. We also have the word can and can't, will and won't, and so on. Okay?
إذا رزان أتمنى أنك تكون تابعت الإجابة للآخر وتعرفت على الإجابة. ناخذ اتصال. خلنا أيضا نذكر في طلبة سألوا عن الأرقام في تويتر 24943708 و24944300. إذا هذه الأرقام البرنامج 24943708 و24944300. أيضا بالنسبة لمشاهدة الحلقة اللي حب يتابعها على اليوتيوب راح تكون أيضا إن شاء الله متاحة. كثير منكم يسأل متى عادة الحلقات تنزل على اليوتيوب. أعتقد أنه بعد البث يمكن في حدود ساعتين ثلاث ساعات ما أدري في 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 هل ناصر أيوة أكد لي ناصر أيوة بالليل متى عموما أعتقد أنه في حدود من 7-8 راح تحصلوها على قناة القناة العامة للتلفزيون السلطنة على اليوتيوب. تدخلوا القناة العامة يعني تلفزيون السلطنة عنده القناة العامة القناة الرياضية وقناة مباشر والقناة العامة في موجود إلها قناة على اليوتيوب. تدخلوا على اليوتيوب أو تدخلوا حتى الموقع مالنا صفحتنا على الفيسبوك راح تحصلوا اللينك موجود مباشرة هناك. في بالنسبة اللي يسألوا متى تنزل أيضا على تويتر احنا موجودين @درز_MOE موجودين أيضا على الفيسبوك. ناخذ اتصال. السلام عليكم.
ألو. وعليكم السلام.
يا مرحبا وسهلا. مين معنا؟
ميراج الحبسي.
مين؟
ميراج الحبسي.
ميراج من وين؟
من مسقط.
من مسقط. ميراج A ولا B؟
A.
تفضل أستاذة فاطمة مع ميراج.
Yes. Hello ميراج. How are you?
Fine. Thank you. How are you?
Fine. You have got a nice name. What does it mean?
Thank you. I have a difficulty to say it in English.
Okay. What's your question? Okay.
My question is which vocabulary we have to study for the final exam, because you know we have a lot of themes and we don't know which one we focus or what to study.
Okay Miraj, well, if I ask you the same question, imagine that I am the student and you are the teacher and I ask you which vocabulary to focus on, what's your answer will be?
Maybe the whole book.
The whole book?
Yes, maybe.
Yes, so because that is the answer. That is the answer, actually. So with the English A, we know that the amount of vocabulary that you have here is somehow tough. I'm going to be realistic this time with you, and I'm going to be with the students. So, but actually what you are going to do here is that you have to read all the vocabulary that you have here, especially the ones that the teacher has focused on in the classroom. And also, you have to put in your mind, Miraj, that you are going to have like from 1 to 2 words, not from this book, from earlier grades, I mean that you have already studied until grade 11. So yeah. The vocabulary question here, it tests a language, the language that you have, and also all the words that will come, they will come from your level. I mean, till yes. grade 12, they will not exceed to the university level or the college level as some students claim. They say sometimes we have vocabulary from university level. No, all the words that you have in the examination, because the exam writer knows exactly what words you have here in the books and also what words you have already taken before or studied before. Are you yes. happy?
Happy, but I'm feeling scared about, you know, the vocabulary, because that's the real problem which we have. Sometimes they bring for us like a tough words. We don't know from where they bring it. It's not from the book. We didn't know it before. So that's why. And sometimes they bring for us very easy words and very easy vocabularies.
Yes, so it depends on the writer, on the examination writer. I'm sure, Miraj, that you will get the full mark, inshallah.
Inshallah, I very hope that.
And the second semester, you will call us telling us that you got 100.
Okay, I'm going to tell you, inshallah.
Inshallah.
Thank you for your help.
Okay.
شكرا لك يا ميراج, نتمنى لك التوفيق إن شاء الله. إذن ناخذ المكالمتين مع بعض, وبعد كذا أيضا راح ناخذ الأسئلة اللي جات على الفيسبوك وعلى التويتر. ناخذ مكالمة. السلام عليكم.
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله.
يا مرحبا وسهلا, من معنا؟
معك الوليد الحرثي.
حياك الوليد, من وين؟
الله يحييك, من مسقط.
من مسقط, A or B الوليد؟
أي
تفضل سؤالك, وبعد كذا راح ناخذ مكالمة ثانية, والأساتذة راح يردوا على السؤالين مرة واحدة. تمام؟
تمام إن شاء الله.
تفضل.
أوكي الوليد, يس.
Teacher, my question is about what is the best way to answer the vocabulary question, especially the missing words.
Okay.
That's all.
That's all. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Okay. شكرا لك الوليد. ناخذ الاتصال الثاني. السلام عليكم. السلام عليكم.
وعليكم السلام.
يا مرحبا وسهلا, من معنا؟
وعليكم السلام.
ايوه بس وطع صوت التلفزيون لو تكرمتي. من معنا؟
الو.
ايوه ايوه, من معنا؟ اسمك من؟
احلام.
أحلام A or B؟
A.
أحلام, معلي اسمعينا من خلال سماعة الهاتف, تمام؟ لأنه الآن صاير صدى وما صايرة تسمعيني بسرعة وتردي متأخرة. تفضلي سؤالك.
إن شاء الله. Hello teacher.
Yes, hello, how are you?
I am fine. What about you?
I'm fine. What's your question?
Can you explain gerund and infinitive?
Gerund and infinitive.
Same five.
أوكي إن شاء الله.
تمام أحلام. هذا بس سؤالك؟
Yes.
شكرا لك يا أحلام. شكرا. شكرا. إذا نأخذ الإجابة على سؤال الوليد. Okay. في البداية سادة فاطمة.
Actually, الوليد ask a question and this question comes in A and B. So إن شاء الله teacher Saeed is going to explain it, which is what is the best way to answer vocabulary 2 question, the missing words.
Okay. Al-Waleed, your question is very good, by the way. Answering vocabulary questions, here you need to know something very important before you come to exam, that you need to be fully aware that you have memorized most of the vocabularies in the book. So, course book or workbook as well. The second thing, you need to know all the meanings, both in English or in Arabic, because in exam, you will be given definition, and these definitions will help you to answer vocabulary questions. Vocabulary number 2, what I'm going to focus on, because it's your question. You will be given a definition. Try to read the definition, very important. Read it. Understand. What does it mean? and then try to see what kind of letters are given there. So sometimes you are, yeah, you will be given the first letter, second or third, or sometimes three letters at first. So when you see these letters, try to go back with your mind. Three letters of which word? Try to remember, try to recall the memory, try to see which word. For example, IMB plus three letters as well. So try to recall the memory. IMB plus three letters. What are, try to think. Yeah, of course, answers is not giving you as a gift. Okay. You need to think as well. So here, you will be given three letters and try to recall the memory as well. That's what it.
سعيد استاذه فاطمه السؤال الثاني بالنسبه لاحلام
اوكي احلام شي اسك اباوت ذا جيرند اند ذا انفينيتيف as we have already said what does infinitive mean infinitive means that you have two and after two you have a verb for example to go to play to read This is what we mean by infinitive, is that we have two, and after the word two, we have the infinitive verb. It means verb without ed, without es, without ing, without anything. This is number one, the infinitive. The gerund. With the gerund, we have verb, and the verb is attached with ing. Like, for example, playing. Playing is considered like gerund. We also have the word like, for example, greeting. Greeting is considered as also a gerund. All you have to do, Ahlam, is that you have to go to the workbook, page 114, 115, and you have to look at this page. In this page here, you have to know which verbs that collocate with gerund and which verb that collocate with infinitive. What do we mean by collocate? We mean that there are some verbs when they come, we immediately write a verb in the infinitive. And there are some verbs when they come, we immediately write the gerund. And there are some verbs that accept both, gerund and infinitive. So go to this page, try to read these words, put them in your mind, and inshallah you will be able to answer this question.
Inshallah, شكرا لك استاذة فاطمة. وايضا احلام ان شاء الله تكون متابعتنا. فاصل نعود ونستكمل ما تبقى من هذه الحلقة المخصصة لمادة اللغة الإنجليزية وبرنامج درس على الهواء كونوا معنا
نولعها نلعب بالجوكر؟ ايه رأيكم الجوكر هو اللي هيلعب بيكم؟
انا معايا ورق
نار
هيولع اللعبة وهيولع الجو
وهيولع كيفه كمان
مات خد لك سنيكرز
ليه؟
انت كل ما بتجوع بتتجنن احسن؟
احسن
انت مش انت وانت جعان سنيكرز ما توقفش
هنوزع تاني
تحية متجددة لكم مشاهدينا الكرام طلبة وطالبات الثاني عشر نتواصل معكم وبرنامج درس على الهواء حلقة اللغة الإنجليزية الحلقة الأولى لهذه المادة هناك حلقة قادمة ستكون يوم الأحد بإذن الله من الآن يعني جهزوا أسئلتكم واستفساراتكم وإن شاء الله نكون نغطي كل الأشياء المطلوبة بالنسبة للمادة أرحب بضيفي مجددا الأستاذ سعيد بن محمد العمري معلم لغة إنجليزية والأستاذة فاطمة بنت عبد الله البريكية معلمة لغة إنجليزية وإحنا كنا قبل الفاصل نتكلم يعني مع بعض او قبل لا نكون على الهواء اثناء الفاصل انه الطلبه قد يواجهوا بعض الصعوبه في مش الصعوبه او ما عارفين كيف يذاكروا اللغه الانجليزيه لدرجه انه كثير من الطلبه يقول لا انجليزي ما بذاكره شو الحل يعني شو كيف ممكن الطالب يعني يذاكر اللغه الانجليزيه
I will say some points and teacher Saeed is going to continue okay the first thing with English language you have, the student has to put in his mind is that it is a language, and since it is a language, so it's logically it's going to be considered of the most skills that we have here, like listening, reading, writing, and also we have the sub skills like vocabulary and also grammar. The first thing is that the student has they have already started studying since the beginning of the semester or since the beginning of the year, and they should also have had enough practice on the main skills, I mean with listening, with reading and writing. If the student, for example, doesn't hold a pen or a pencil and start writing and practicing and showing the teacher what he has already written so that he gets some feedback about it, he will not be able to write anything. So practice comes like the first thing. Bring, now Teacher Saeed has told you about Zawiyati. You can go there, collect all the materials that you have there, whether for English A or for English B, it depends on you. And sit down on a chair and start answering questions from the exam papers. Because if you are able now to answer an examination from an exam paper, inshallah you will be able to answer the examination that you will have, like for example, by next week. Why? Because the same target is there, which is practicing and answering questions related to a certain skill. With vocabulary and grammar, you should put in your mind that the vocabulary and the grammar, they come from the book. What does this mean? It means go to the book, try to find out what are the grammar rules that you have, what are the vocabulary that you have there. You should practice spelling also, not only memorizing the word like the meaning. You have to spell out the word. You have also to go back to the basic rules you have already studied, like past simple, present simple, future simple, because they come in the exam, prepositions and so on. So if you can add anything.
Yeah, sometimes, Mr. Khalfan, students are complaining English is difficult. And the reason is because most students are suffering from the lack of vocabulary. They don't have much vocabulary that can help them to produce English. As we know, English is subject, verb, object. If you don't know vocabularies, how can you produce good English? If you know just I, but you don't know the verb, how can you produce an English? So here I'm going to say, try to enrich your knowledge with more words in English, more vocabularies. The first thing, when you notice the new vocabularies, try to write them down, put them in your mind, and try it a week after, try to go back and try to memorize it as well. One more thing, try to use it in a sentence. Give your teacher, let him or let her mark it. So check if you are using a good English here. One more thing, students are complaining that vocabularies are not from the book. Why is that? One or two? No. So if you go, for example, in B, some students or most students in Oman, they are not studying self-study. It's not teacher's role to teach you, it's self-study. You have to study. You need to get the answers, you need to get the meaning. One exam was mentioning put on and put off, put out and put aside, but student don't know the meaning. Come on, teacher's not his role to teach you self-study. That's why. So you need guys to study self-study as well. It's not out of the book. It's not out of the book, it's in the book. But yes, teacher is not teaching. It's not his role. So try, guys, to have, for example, new exercise book, try to write down whatever new vocabularies, write the meaning, whatever in Arabic, no problem. So try to memorize it, give it to your teacher, and practice. Practice makes perfect. That's it.
انا 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 متحمس كذا مع الاستاذ سعيد يعني زين هو يعطيكم الانستركشنز الجميل هذيلا والادفايزز الرائعات وباسلوب كذا يعني انا لو كنت مكانكم كطالب بالفعل يعني راح اتحمس كثير وراح اخذ هذيلا النصائح ايضا ربما من النقاط اللي راح تثيروها وانا متاكد انه في الحلقه الثانيه راح يثيروا مشكله الليسننج يعني و they can't hear good or they didn't understand what they are saying in the recording. الآن لحد الامتحان أعتقد عندهم أربع أيام. How they can practice listening?
Practicing listening. The first advice that guys can Yeah, it's not the time to give advice now. It's before. I always advising my students to hear English news, especially whatever channel in English. So try to practice. Let your ear practice the language. You always practice in Arabic. Why didn't you give 1 hour for your ear to practice, for example, English? Because listening is practicing as well. It's not only talking. If you're listening very carefully, you will talk in English. That's one thing. In exam, Mr. Khalfan, they are complaining as well about listening. We can't hear. The first thing, when you receive exam paper, try to read listening questions. Read. Read and read. Try to understand. Underline any keyword. You don't have to hear everything, by the way. Because the questions in exam asking you for answers. They are not asking you for everything to make a summary. So just listen and try to get the answer. How can you get the answer? Try to underline keywords. Try to understand. Try to read. Before TV is switching on, for example, before the teacher is coming for TV, for example, for listening. So try to practice. Yeah, of course, this is a little bit late to give advice. But inshallah.
There are 4 days before the
exam.
Yeah,
4 days. Try to let your ear practicing. 1 hour a day, it's okay. Not more than, because you need to study. Try to study as well.
Okay, there is another good news about listening. As you maybe you remember that last year.
The problem of the tape recorder.
Yes, the problem of the tape recorder. And I just said it here in the program, and I don't know that they would take it seriously in the Ministry of Education. Mm-hmm. This year, they are not going to be like tape scripts. They are going to be on CDs. Mm-hmm. And the quality of CD is very
better.
And also you will be able to hear clearly what is there. So thank you very much for the ministry and also for this program.
Yeah, it's a good news, really. It's a good
news. Yes, from grade 10 to grade 12, they have
it
on
in the
CDs.
جميل. نرجع وناخذ اتصالات. ناخذ مكالمة. السلام عليكم.
وعليكم السلام.
يا مرحبا وسهلا، من معنا؟
عبد الرحمن الشقطي.
عبد الرحمن، من وين يا عبد الرحمن؟
من مسقط.
من مسقط، حياك عبد الرحمن. A or B عبد الرحمن؟
A.
A. تفضل.
Yes عبد الرحمن، how are you?
I'm fine. How are you?
Yes I'm fine. What's your question?
I have difficulty with grammar with the past perfect. On page 21.
Page 21?
Yes.
Wait a minute, Abdul Rahman, don't go. Okay, past perfect. What do you want here? What is not clear here?
I didn't understand. They say use the past perfect for expression. I don't understand what you mean.
Okay.
I see the example, I don't know.
Okay. I will explain generally the past perfect, the rule of the past perfect, and also we are going to have examples. For students in the houses who wants to follow us, here we have it in this page, page 21. Abdul Rahman here asked us about this rule, which is past perfect. So all of you, let's look here on the screen and see what do we mean here by past perfect. Actually, first of all, the meaning of past perfect, if we just look here, past perfect means if we come to the timeline that we have, we consider this the past, this one here is the present, and this one here is the future. Since it is past, so we are going to talk about this area, which is the past area. Past perfect means that we have two actions that happened in the past, like for example here and here in this area. But one action happened before the other one. So the action that happens as number one, we consider it as past perfect. So the meaning of past perfect is that we have two actions happened in the past, one action happened before the other one. Now let's move to the structure of past perfect. We have here subject. Then we have here had, and then here we have the past participle, the third verb, and here we have the complement or the object of the sentence, okay? So if we just look here,
If we just look here, as here it is written in the book that we have past perfect to express events which happened before other events in the past. Like for example, Ahmed. Okay, had met Faisal when he, for example, came here. If we just look here, we have here two actions, the coming action and also the meeting action. We can understand from this sentence that first of all, Ahmed had met Faisal, then after that he came to the house or to the party or wherever. The second one is that we can use past perfect with the phrases that we have here. If, only, and also I have the one which is I wish. Like for example, I wish I had, for example, visited my friends. I wish I had visited my friends. So here we have with this statement, I wish I, or he wishes he, or they wish they. We have here past perfect, which means had plus the past participle. And also we have it with reported speech and also with statement and questions. Like the teacher asked me why I hadn't done my homework. So the statement will be why I had not done my homework will follow this type of structure, which is subject, had. If it is positive, if it is negative, we are going to have had not or hadn't plus the past participle plus the object.
إذن عبد الرحمن معنا؟
نعم.
واضح الإجابة؟
واضح.
شكرا لك عبد الرحمن. شكرا. خلنا هنا ناخذ ملاحظة جات من بعض الطلبة من مدرسة الخليل بن أحمد الفراهيدي بجنوب الباطنة أعتقد. خلنا نقرأ الملاحظة. نحن طلاب الباطنة في مدرسة الخليل بن أحمد الفراهيدي عندنا أخطاء في الرقم المدني، وإحنا قدمنا شكاوي حال مدير المركز وما حصلنا جواب. أرجو منكم متابعة الموضوع في الوزارة، لأنه راح يصير غلط في النسبة والتسجيل في المركز قبول الموحد بجنوب الباطنة لمصنعة بالتحديد ودام الغاف. عموما إن شاء الله ولا يهمكم، بس أنا أتمنى أنه من أنتم مطرشين الرسالة هذه عن طريق صفحتنا على الفيسبوك كمنشور، لكن أنا أتمنى مش كمنشور ترسلوها على نظام الخاص، الرسائل الخاصة أو النظام الخاص، ترسلوا لي رقم معين ممكن نتواصل فيه معاكم عشان نعرف وش اللي صاير بالضبط، وبعد كده بنتواصل مع المديرية هناك في جنوب الباطنة أو حتى في المديرية العامة للتقييم التربوي بالوزارة. احنا تقريبا خلصنا الجزئية الخاصة باللغة الإنجليزية في حلقة اليوم. عندنا كذا فقرة من خلالها الطلبة والطالبات ايضا يخبرون بعض المواقف اللي قد تصادفهم اثناء فترة المذاكرة او اثناء فترة اداء الامتحان. نسمع الموقف من احدى الطالبات، وايضا راح تكون عندنا هناك الأستاذة منى راح ترد على الطالبة هذه وبتخبرها كيف ممكن تتصرف في مثل هذه المواقف. إن كانت هذه المواقف على لسان طالبة فهي بالتأكيد قد تتكرر أو تتشابه مع طلاب آخرين، وتبقى الفائدة ويبقى أيضا الكلام والحل الموجه للجميع ولكل من تتشابه معه مثل هذه الحالات. دعونا نتابع.
أنا طالبة مزلة بنت علي الغسيني من الصف الثاني عشر. من ضمن المشكلات اللي تواجهني أثناء فترة الاختبارات أنه لحظة استلامي لورقة الاختبارية أشعر بالارتباك والقلق والتوتر لدرجة يجعلني أشعر وكأني لم أذاكر أو لم أكتفي بالقدر المناسب للوصول للاختبار.
إذا هذه مزنة الغسيني تطرح هذا الموقف أو هذا المشكلة اللي تواجهها بأنه أثناء الامتحان يصير عندها نوع من القلق ونوع من التوتر نوع من الارتباك، وخاصة متى يصير هالشيء؟ لحظة استلام الورقة الامتحانية، يعني الطالب يكون جاي مذاكر من البيت ومستعد وجاهز للامتحان، بس أول ما يجلس على المقعد ويبدأ توزيع الأوراق أول ما يستلم ورقة الامتحان تصير له الحالة. عموما الأستاذة منى العمرية أيضا ترد على الطالبة مزنة، دعونا نسمع ماذا تقول.
بنقول لك يا مزنة أن ده شعور طبيعي أو ده شيء طبيعي، أن أي طالب أو أي حتى فرد بيكون في موقف اختبار وفي لجنة امتحان بينتابه شعور بالتوتر والقلق والارتباك في البداية، لكن بمجرد ما تبدأي تقرأي الأسئلة بمجرد ما تبدأي تندمجي في الإجابات على هذه الأسئلة بالتدريج بيزول هذا التوتر والقلق. جزء من القلق بيكون قلق صحي بيساعدش على أنك تتذكري، بيساعدك على أنك تزداد مهاراتك، تزداد إمكانياتك، تزداد استيعابك لكل ما سبق دراسته. أي أن القلق ممكن نستخدمه قلق صحي وليس بصورة أن هو القلق المرضي.
إذن أنا أريد منكم أيضا تعقيب، وما علي خلي هالمرة بالعربي. زين أستاذ سعيد وأستاذ فاطمة، هالمواقف تصير صح في الامتحانات، حتى أحيانا في الامتحانات العادية مش الامتحانات النهائية، حتى في الامتحانات الفترية وأنتم كمعلمين تواجهوا هالشيء، كيف ممكن الطالب يتصرف بالنسبة لكم؟ خلينا نأخذ الإجابة منك أستاذ سعيد.
نعم، كثير من الطلاب اللي يشتكوا أنه والله لما ندخل الاختبار نحس عمارة أن كل الأسئلة وكل اللي ذاكرناه روح، وهذه طبعا احنا في الانجليش وي كول ات اكزام انكزايتي، قلق الامتحان. قلق الامتحان النتائج عكسية على الطالب نفسه. أحيانا حد الطلاب يقعدوا يذاكروا قبل الامتحان بخمس دقائق أو بعشر دقائق أو يتناقشوا الأسئلة أو يتناقشوا الأذى، فهذا كله يعمل قلق للطالب، يتفاجأ بأسئلة الامتحان. أحيانا السؤال مش صعب بس الطالب نفسه بيفكر أن هذا السؤال هو صعب، لكن لو فكر الطالب واسترجع معلوماته أكيد 100% أنه بيحصل الإجابة وبيقدر أنه يسترجع للأشياء اللي ذاكرها. فأنا أقول أن معظم الطلاب المفروض يبتعدوا شوي عن المناقشة قبل الاختبارات.
بالنسبة لك سادة فاطمة، خلنا نسمع هالمرة باللغة العربية.
بالنسبة لي يعني هذه الحالة الشعورية اللي يمر فيها يعني بعض من الطلبة والطالبات أثناء الامتحانات أو قبيل الامتحان احنا نصادفها يعني كثير في المدارس معنا وفي الفصول الدراسية، أحيانا حتى امتحان عادي يعني مجرد أن كوز امتحان قصير يعني مدته لا تتعدى العشر دقائق أو الربع ساعة، لكن تشكل قلق عند بعض الطلاب. الحل الوحيد اللي هو كثرة الاستغفار وتلاوة يعني بعض الآيات القرآنية اللي تهدي النفس، يعتبر الاستغفار يعني دواء يعني رائع في لمعظم يعني المشاكل اللي يعاني منها الإنسان فينا، وما في شيء أفضل من قول الله سبحانه وتعالى ألا بذكر الله تطمئن القلوب. فالشخص اللي يعني الطالب يجب أن يتوكل أول شيء على الله سبحانه وتعالى، لازم تكون ثقته بنفسه عالية جدا وكبيرة، بمعنى أني أنا ذاكرت واستعديت للامتحان بما هو يؤهلني لحل هذه الامتحانات. قبل الامتحان بعشر دقائق أو بربع ساعة أبدأ أستغفر ربي، أذكر يعني أتلو يعني في نفسي بعض الآيات اللي تهدئ من روعي، وإن شاء الله تسكنهم السكينة والطمأنينة ويحلوا الامتحان على خير.
ممكن يحصل هالشيء في امتحان اللغة الإنجليزية، يعني قلنا يمكن لأنه هذا امتحان لغة، لكن عادة يحصل هذا في الامتحان اللي محتاج إلى معلومات، استرجاع معلومات معينة، ممكن يحصل هذا الشيء في امتحان اللغة الإنجليزية.
أيوة يحصل في جميع الامتحانات.
في جميع الامتحانات. أيوة. نعم. إذن إحنا وصلنا لنهاية حلقة اليوم من برنامج درس على الهواء. أنا أتمنى أنكم تكونوا ما أدري أستاذ سعيد وأستاذ فاطمة عندكم حسابات على الفيسبوك ولا؟ موجود عندكم حسابات على الفيسبوك. أتمنى أنكم أيضا تدخلوا صفحتنا صفحة البرنامج، وهنا يمكن بعض الأسئلة اللي ما لحقنا نرد عليها تردوا على الطلبة يعني خلال الأيام الجاية، لأن في بعض الملاحظات هنا يمكن جات متأخرة ما قدرنا نرد عليها أيضا حتى بسبب الوقت. تدخلوا على صفحة برنامج درس عليها وكذا ويصير خلاص تمام. حلو جميل يعني أنا أحييك. عموما أشكرك جدا أستاذ سعيد بن محمد العمري معلم لغة إنجليزية، شكرا لك. وأيضا شكرا لك لأستاذة فاطمة بنت عبد الله البريكية معلمة لغة إنجليزية، شكرا لك. شكرا. إذا أذكر فقط جمعة وسبت عطلة نهاية أسبوع، إن شاء الله كذا في خلال هذه العطلة تركزوا في مذاكرتكم، تستعدوا لامتحاناتكم القادمة. يوم الأحد امتحان الكيمياء بإذن الله. بالنسبة لبرنامجنا أيضا حلقتي الجمعة والسبت راح يكون إن شاء الله لمادة الكيمياء. نلتقيكم يوم الغد، أتمنى لكم مذاكرة مفيدة إن شاء الله. هذه تحياتي، تحيات فريق العمل وتحيات مخرج البرنامج بدر العميري. إلى اللقاء.